Call this meeting to order. Roll call.
Madam Chair, Tonita Lule Hiron.
Present.
Commissioner David Olivetti Jr.
Here.
Commissioner David Romero.
Here.
Commissioner Amber Davis. Commissioner Vince Howell.
Here.
Commissioner Barbara Casey.
Here.
Thank you, Madam Chair. We have a quorum.
Thank you very much.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Counselor Howell.
Moment of silence. Please keep in mind all of the residents that are in North Carolina, South Carolina, and Eastern Seaboard. I know they have some devastation in the past. So keep them in mind.
Music is on. Put this music on.
Yep.
No.
There's music playing through the speakers.
No, not mine. Mine's off.
Oh.
Is it the radio official? No? Is anybody linked to the... No?
I don't have mine.
Mine's off. I mean...
Item on the agenda, Madam Chair, is the approval of the agenda.
What's the pleasure of the board?
Madam Chair.
Counselor Romero.
I have a question. I submitted a request for an agenda item, and it was also voted upon unanimously by the Board of Commissioners. I'm disappointed that it wasn't on the agenda.
Yes, of course. I called the DC office, and I requested an independent audit from a team unaffiliated with the New Mexico HUD office, and so we can have a fair and impartial audit from the housing. And pretty much I was advised to hold off on that resolution until their independent audit.
Did you have some type of communication? Let us know, or disappointed that you didn't call and let me know.
Well, actually, I was putting together a memo, but I have a million things to do, and I will be letting you have that memo. But that's exactly right.
All of us?
Oh, everybody, of course. You will all get a copy of it. That's right. Yes, sir.
Madam Mayor, I also think that since all of us did vote unanimously, that we should have been alerted that you have you are not going to have the meeting that we asked. I think it's important that communication is made to us, especially when we unanimously voted for having this.
I actually wrote the memo, Counselor Howell. I just finalized it because I'm looking at a couple of other things before I put anything in it.
We should have been alerted to that.
Okay, no apologies. But who would be? Thanks, please.
Madam Mayor, just one last thing, I guess, if you put out, I mean, let us know who you spoke to, because I don't know.
Yes, everything will be on the memo.
The authority of chairman is to... letting us know what.
I'm sorry, could you repeat?
I don't know if, you know, we're a board of commissioners, you know, for housing, and I'll just leave it at that.
I'll get you the.
It should have been what he's saying, like, it should have been a decision made by the board, not by an individual.
Well, actually, for the independent audit, Actually, you need to review the rules of the chairman for the HUD because actually we have quite a bit of authority. Probably more than it is in the charter. But I will be getting over. Thank you very much. What's the pleasure? You don't have really anything to do. What is the pleasure? What? Approval of this approval of the agenda.
Madam Mayor?
Councilor?
Approval of the agenda is this?
Thank you. Okay, welcome.
Commissioner Casey?
No.
Commissioner Howell?
No.
Commissioner Romero?
Yes.
Commissioner Uribe?
Yes.
I have a motion by Commissioner, first by Commissioner Uribe, a second by Commissioner Romero.
Yes, absolutely.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Commissioners, the next item on the agenda is the approval of minutes of August the 15th, 2015.
No public input?
I'm sorry, Madam Chair, there is no public input. That's after the minutes.
Madam Chair?
Yes.
I move approval of the minutes as amended.
Do we have any presentations? Oh, the minutes, here we are. I jumped into the public input, sorry. Okay, go ahead.
I have a motion by Commissioner Casey. Is there a second for the approval of the minutes?
Do I have a second? Roll call?
Second.
Roll call.
Commissioner Howell?
Yes.
Commissioner Romero?
Yes.
Commissioner Casey?
Yes.
Commissioner Uliwari?
Yes.
I have a motion by Commissioner Casey. A second by Commissioner Romero. Thank you, Madam Chair. Motion carries.
Thank you.
Next item is public input. We do not have anybody signed up for public input at this time. Next item on the agenda is our presentation, our finance report by our financial specialist, Natasha Martinez-Padilla.
Madam Chair, Commissioners, thank you. In front of you this evening is the revenue and expenditure report. With 17% of our budget being lapsed for fiscal year 19, our dwelling rents are coming in a little bit lower than expected, but we should be getting them up. They're actually right on line if you look at the collections that we're supposed to be getting. Our operating subsidy, we're recording it on an accrual basis, so it should be right in line this year as well. Our other income is higher. We're hoping that line stays low. We don't want to get above the $10,000 because sometimes that revenue that we're billing out doesn't necessarily always get paid back. And then our transfers in, we're at the $10,000 being transferred from general fund is all that we've received so far, or the 17% of the $10,000. And then as far as the expenditures go, our employee expense and our operating expense are at about 13% of our total operations. And so we're a little bit lower than what we expected, but that's kind of a good thing. Thank you. That's the end of the report.
Okay, questions, comments? Councilor Hall.
Yes, thank you, Madam Commissioner. Since you had brought the subject up of I guess DC is going to have an audit.
Well, I have to bring the subject up because you asked. So.
Right. So, are they going to do a forensic audit on our financials?
I don't know if they're going to conduct the audit, but I know that I was assured that they would do the names. The Albuquerque HUD office would not be involved in the audit, so this is a very impartial audit of everything. And I don't know to what degree they're going to investigate, but I think it's going to be quite good.
So did we usurp the Albuquerque HUD office authority?
I'm sorry?
Did we usurp the authority of the HUD in Albuquerque by going to D.C. to ask for this audit?
Well, consistent with policy, if I feel that it is not in the best interest to transfer a housing project straight up to Raton, then I feel that I have the authority, consistent with policy, to request an independent audit. So, yes, I did my job.
And then again, I'd like to repeat what was said, that it should have been the board's decision.
Actually, not on a situation like that, because as the chairman of the board, I do have the authority to request that independent audit.
And the chairman should have gone through the board and informing them.
But you will be getting informational memorandum to that effect.
I just think it's very disappointing that we went this route.
Well, I think what's disappointing is that you have someone at the HUD office calling meetings that could involve negotiations and that could pose a threat to the city's negotiating team. And I think that's more disappointing. That's something that we should genuinely be concerned of. And I did what I felt was in the best interest of the city of Las Vegas and the Housing Authority.
Yeah.
I did my job. Thank you.
Madam Mayor, to add to that, what policies are you talking, I mean, which policies are you talking that you have?
There's a public housing authority policies and the rules within that authority.
Do we have?
They should have them. And if not, we can get them. So.
On that point, Madam Mayor, it was my understanding that because this is a political body, the mm-hmm. council, that the rules that the council functions by are the same rules that this commission functions by.
Yes, and there's
I'm wondering why you would go with the housing language now, but you have them before.
I don't know
and
what you're talking about. Yeah.
Well, you're referring to, you know, the guidelines for mm-hmm. for the housing authority.
Well, both the city of Las Vegas operates under certain guidelines, and the housing board operates under certain guidelines.
Well, that was not my understanding.
That is the way it should be. But I will get those policies.
And, you know, you really should have had them ready for us this evening so that we could have looked at them.
Well, you can research your own policies, Councilor Casey.
I will do that.
Do that, please. Okay, thank you. And as far as making the decision, I have to do what's in the best interest of the city. I also discovered that the receivership, as you have threatened openly and publicly, is absolutely untrue. We do not go into receivership because the HUD Albuquerque office determines that. The final determination will come from the DC office.
And just to clarify,
we're going to go into receivership.
Please?
I have the floor. And that is untrue, an absolutely untrue statement. Councilor Casey.
This is what I was told. I was merely repeating.
I know
what
we have the memos.
And so for you to say that I am threatening receivership is absolutely unfair and inaccurate.
That was your statement.
It is inaccurate. But I didn't say I'm going to make them
you
go
said
into
we,
receivership.
No, but you were a scare tactic. You know, we're going to go into receivership, and that is not the truth at all.
Well, that was not my purpose.
Well, that's exactly what was
it's how you
was
took it.
No, the public took it that way too, Councilor Casey. Okay, let's move on. Any other questions?
I believe the memo from HUD had referred to the receivership, because if we don't do the transfer, then the possibility of the receivership, and that's where mm-hmm. Councilor Casey had referred to.
Yeah, but there was certain information in the memo that was misleading.
That's true, but Councilor Casey did not personally threaten the receivership. She actually referred to the memo that was sent by HUD in regards to possible receivership.
Yes,
and that's correct.
I read the memo, but I also recall the statement. So the bottom line is, Councilor Howell, that the memo that was presented to Councilor Casey was misleading, and I had to have clarification. I have to protect the interests of the city with regards to any negotiations, and that's exactly what I'm doing. I'm doing the job.
But the memo went to all of us, not just to Councilor Casey.
No, I understand that. But the receivership to me was an immediate threat, and I don't believe that that's how we need to go, because we have to go into negotiations if that's what they want. I don't have a problem with that, but the negotiating team is very specific. Okay. Any other questions?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Councilor?
On this financial report, Ms. Natasha,
mm-hmm.
On our regular council meeting financial reports, it says 16% has lapsed. And here you have 17%. Is there a difference? Is there a reason for the difference?
I just divided the 2 by 12.
Okay.
I rounded up. It's 16.66%, so I put it at 17% instead of going down
fairly,
to this.
That's fairly close, and that's good.
Okay, I just wanted to know the difference.
Sorry.
That's good.
Questions, comments?
Okay, let's continue. Next item on the agenda, Madam Chair, Commissioners, is the Housing Director's monthly report. Maintenance continues to work on unit turnarounds, groundkeeping work orders due to the operations. You may have noticed, I'm sure a lot of you have noticed, the fence on New Mexico Avenue was just damaged by a vehicle. So we are in the process of going through the insurance to try and take care of that. Also for housing management, the waiting list manager continues to accept and process applications daily. Housing managers continue with their day-to-day operations, including lease enforcement, annual recertifications, annual inspections, code enforcement, as well as meeting with residents to discuss lease violations and seek to resolve any issues as they occur. Training, housing staff continues to attend the monthly training provided by risk management. Natasha and I did attend the 2018 housing summit last week. So we did get a lot of good information and a lot of networking happened there. Projects, the roofing project still is ongoing throughout housing. The two unit remodel project on Sandoval is also on its way and we hope to have it completed by the end of September. We're hoping. The de minimis, as I reported last month, we did receive the written approval from the Special Application Center. So we are beginning the process on the de minimis application or de minimis process. That is all I have for my director's report.
Okay, thank you very much. Questions, comments, Councillor Howe.
Thank you, Madam Commissioner. Ms. Barbara, Ms. Padilla, I'm sorry. We spoke at your office in regards to resident.
Yes.
What was the status on that?
I'm sorry, I didn't call you back. I had a lot of things, but I did speak to, there was no work orders, so we did contact the tenant himself because he had not called our office. The first that I had heard of it was from you, so we did make sure that we reached out to see if there was an issue, and as far as I know, there isn't.
Yeah, please check into that, because he explained to me that he had been calling the HUD, your office, and I don't know if you're not getting that information.
Right. Madam Chair, Commissioners, I did ask everybody, though, in the office, our admin who takes the calls, and the housing manager for that area, she said she had not spoken to him at all.
Okay.
So I hope that they do follow, you know, and because we will take care of it. Okay. They let us know of the issue.
Sometimes communication doesn't get back to the whole team, so that's why I was saying. Thank you.
My man.
Councillor Lee.
Ms. Padilla. On the wall that's right by Daylight Donuts, have you guys taken a look at that?
Madam Chair, Commissioner, I was just informed that it is starting to lean.
Yes, ma'am.
So I have to have Frank go and assess it, our maintenance supervisor, and see what we need to do about that. I was just made aware of that.
I did go by there and check it out because I had the owner from Daylight Donuts confront me and ask me about the wall because it looks like it's moving in two parts of it now.
I haven't seen it myself, but we will.
It's liability for, I don't know if it's between the owner and you guys, the city. You know,
that's something that we'll have to look at to see because I'm not sure who initially put the wall. So we'll definitely look into that because I was informed that it was leaning. So that is a concern. We'll take care of it.
Okay,
thank
you.
If it's not us, we will make sure that whoever is responsible for it will take care of it.
Okay, maybe on the next meeting, we have some answers.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, ma'am.
Councillor Gomez. I don't know if this would fall under the commissioner's report.
Well, you can hold off on the commissioner's report if you want, unless you have questions.
I'll hold off on the minute.
But it is a commissioner's report.
We are now.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. First question, and I don't know the compliance report that we received in the audit findings. I know there was some issues with policies. Where are we with those? Have they been submitted or?
Madam Chair, or Commissioners, I wouldn't have the answer to that. That would be the city manager.
As far as I You did submit everything that we had turned over to you, correct?
Yes, we did.
Yes, we submitted it. We just, they haven't been presented to the commission.
And they won't be presented until we get a review. They probably, I am expecting them to review it first, give us any changes or never.
When did they submit the report? I'm sorry.
February 28th.
And we have not received anything from HUD yet?
No.
Okay, I had an opportunity to talk to, because I wanted to know a couple of things, but I'll talk about the other issue later. Is that they wanted us to present the policy prior to them looking at it. I mean, it's our policy. So why, I mean, we're waiting for them and they're waiting for us. So
well, and that, this is the first time here that they were waiting.
When did you talk to her?
Friday, when was that?
We spoke to Mandy, I gather?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, because I wanted to know why the meeting, it was a work session that was scheduled and it was canceled. And so I wanted to find out why it was canceled.
And what did she tell you?
That there was no public notice of a possible quorum.
Okay, thank you.
So I don't know, I mean, that was, I mean, first I want to go back to, you know, those findings, you know, we can't just forget about them. I mean, until whatever, you know, you did in DC or
she still has to do her job. She has to submit back to the city either the fact that she accepts or she rejects the policies and the responses.
Madam Chair, Commissioners, that was included in last month's meeting.
I can't hear you.
That was included in the packet last month's meeting. We did start discussing it.
So we still have not had a response, correct?
That was her response, so I believe they're waiting for us to...
To respond
to it? To complete the incomplete findings.
Oh, was that it, Amory?
We did submit the accounting policies on February 27th. We submitted them in draft form. We preferred that they review them because state standards and federal standards are different. We were not sure whether she was going to ask us to include any of the other federal standards that needed to be included, if in fact they needed to be. And I felt that it was best for us to send them in as draft form. I didn't want to come back to you, have you adopt something, and then have to come back to you and amend the resolution for adoption. Now, if Mandy did indicate to you on Friday, I understand. Or sometimes.
Well, the day of that meeting, was it Monday?
I don't know.
The day that
Tuesday,
session
I think it was Tuesday.
Yeah, Tuesday.
If she did indicate that Tuesday. She was waiting for us to set up the adoption, then of course the housing, staff at housing can bring those back to you, have you approve them, and then you can resubmit as an approval. That should be a very easy case.
Okay. And the other question that I had is the resolution. I mean, I'm still confused, Madam Mayor, as to how you went about and you know got in contact with DC. We had an attorney that drafted this resolution and got a copy of it. And I was sort of surprised because last week when we had our special meeting on Monday, she said that she got it done that week. Mm-hmm. But yet we were never notified. I mean, I have to, you know, request it through you and the city manager.
I had informed Councilor Romero, Commissioner Romero, the council that we would need to move into negotiation. So that is exactly what was holding up the resolution and me bringing the resolution to the table. There's a lot of points and important factors that could benefit the city that if we don't negotiate those appropriately and we just turn everything over without negotiations, I don't think it would be in the best interest of the city.
But that's where the resolution was going to start?
No, the negotiation would just be enter into negotiations, but then after I had been in contact with the HUD office, the DC office, they said to hold off on everything because they were getting mixed messages, is pretty much what I was told, from the Albuquerque HUD office versus what we had in our possessions. The records were not matching. The information was not matching.
Okay, because even like this resolution, I don't know what we paid our attorney, but even this resolution that was drafted by her doesn't even, I mean, know, she gave us sort of this guideline, and this resolution doesn't even anywhere near it. I asked her if she had been in contact with the attorney. She hadn't. I guess, have you guys seen this?
No, we haven't seen that.
And if I remember correctly, when we gave her...
But they had to have seen it. You got it in the packet.
No, not that resolution. The only resolution...
Is that the one that you add, the draft resolution?
This is the one that was done by Danielle Smith, our attorney.
Yeah, that's a draft resolution that you went and took to Cassandra to put on the agenda. Yeah, of course you saw it. You had to have.
No, we didn't see it.
Did Cassandra ever...
That resolution was never taken.
Oh, yes, of course. Careful. Yeah. Okay, so no, the draft resolution is a draft for that purpose.
I remember the direction that we gave her is that she would work with housing staff. Mm-hmm. And then somewhere down the line, there's a big
We were going to work with housing staff, but let me tell you what happened. I looked at the policies and I found a policy that said that we are not to have any of the, there's certain individuals who can negotiate, and housing staff was not one of them. So the first draft that was written pretty much was consistent with what Mandy wanted, so we had to redraft another draft and resubmit a brand new resolution that was consistent with policy. And then I was in contact with the DC office, and I told them about my concerns, the fact that she had called a meeting, and I've already explained this. I don't want to repeat
myself. And then the meeting, to my knowledge, was an informational meeting to the community as to possibility.
Yeah, and that was her decision to cancel. We didn't get involved in that meeting.
I was told otherwise that...
Well, who told you?
It was Mandy.
This
public notice of a possible quorum, an email was sent out to city staff about, you know, the public, you know, put it in the newspaper that, you know, there might be a possible quorum. And that never happened.
So, okay. Well, I didn't call the meeting. And it wasn't a city called meeting. She called the workshop. She called it, not me.
But, okay, I won't.
So Mandy told you that?
That there was no public notice of a possible quorum. And I've seen these done, you know, when there's public meetings that, you know, I know they do them. We did them at the schools.
Well,
if there was a public meeting and there's a possibility that the majority of the, at that time, the school board was there.
Well, apparently she contacted, I'm not certain if it was our attorney or our clerk, and told her that she was just going to post a notice. So we were under the assumption that that's what she was going to do. I don't know anymore.
I think there's a...
Okay. Thank you. Councillor Hull?
Commissioner, thank you, Madam Commissioner. You had mentioned that the policy that you read stated that staff should not get involved.
Yes,
with it.
There's a policy.
Does it state that the director of our housing authority and the finance specialist cannot get involved?
Absolutely. That's exactly what it says. So the only individuals, we've got 1 minute, the only individuals that will get involved are the city manager, the city attorney, and with regards to the actual negotiations, and then we'll bring it to the council. Because see, right now, if you look at the policy, the way it's written, Councillor Howell, there is a huge conflict of interest with the staff getting involved in the negotiations. Huge.
But they're the ones that develop the budget, and they're the ones that give direction to the housing authority.
Yes, but so they're also involved in benefiting from the housing authority if they transfer.
I'm confused there. The statement was made that the resolution was going to be done by the attorney and involve the staff to look at the resolution to make sure that the wording
yes,
and everything is
right. Yes,
and
then there was policy that I found.
There wasn't any negotiation on the resolution. It was just the fact that the resolution needed to be stated that we can move forward to step number two or step number one.
Yeah, but there's a policy, Councillor Howell. And in that policy, it says that the staff does not have the right to negotiate.
But that's not a negotiation.
Well, we are going to go into negotiations, because that's what Mandy requested.
But for that resolution is not...
Yes, part of the resolution that Mandy put together was that the staff negotiate. We are not going to allow the staff to negotiate if the policy states that it has to be certain individuals. We're going to stick to policy.
And then what about the board? The board, why does the board exist if we are not involved in
Because that is an administrative function, Councillor Howell. We know this already. We've discussed this for years. And then we bring to the board the final recommendations, because there's a lot of things that this board is unfamiliar with that have occurred and that are excellent negotiating points on behalf of the city. And I would rather not discuss them, and I'm not going to in an open meeting.
Well, I just, one last comment is, here's the draft. The draft says nothing about the employees.
The first draft did. But Mandy, if you go back to it, the first draft, it included the employees for negotiations.
But the draft was ours. And then the second one...
No, but that was actually Mandy's draft to us, correct?
It was actually Julian Badalai, was it, Mandy?
Yes.
But yeah, it was from the head office in Albuquerque.
Yes, of course. Because there was the other memos, and they came from Mandy's.
Yeah. And the second...
And the other part is that I'll differ with you on this one, is that we're one of the few cities that are actually housing authority, you know, that we oversee the housing authority. Mm-hmm. So, you know, that there's policy that says the city manager and the...
Yes, there is policy, and it's cited in that draft that you have, I believe.
Because we're one of the few, I think we're one of the only four mm-hmm. municipalities that...
And, you know, I've talked to a lot of the individuals in the community, and they have all said, do not let go of the housing authority if you don't have to. And we're talking a lot of ex-councillors, ex-mayors, and they believe that it should stay here, and it should stay under, and if it's not under the city administration, under a local administration. So, okay, let's move on. We're running out of time here. 6:03, we have another meeting. Okay, any other questions, comments?
Are the commissioner's reports completed?
Who is next? Councillor Casey.
I don't have anything to report.
Okay, Councillor Howell, I think
no.
Councillor Ulletti.
What?
Do you have any comments?
No comments.
Okay, thank you very much. Let's continue.
Madam Chair, next item on the agenda is executive session. Is there any need for executive?
I don't believe we have any need for it. Okay.
And the next item is adjournment.
Okay, thank you very much. I need a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Do I have a second?
Sorry, there were three
that everybody jumped in. So somebody has a second roll call. Thank you.
Commissioner O'Neill-Levy?
Yes.
Commissioner Casey?
Yes.
Commissioner Romero?
Yes.
Commissioner Howell?
Yes.
Who was the first? I'm sorry. And the second.
Well,
Casey
all
made a motion, and the second was made by Commissioner Romero. Thank you, Madam Chair. Motion carried.
Thank you very much.